It starts with a voice, a thought, and a dream. To awake as women of the earth, endowed with wings to fly. To harness renewable energy of earth, water, wind, and fire. The power is in your hands. In the heavens and seas and everything between, I shall walk the earth as a queen.
We'll be right back. Abel Lipmanan, Camarines Sur.
Jennifer Aidita Hapor, Lucena City.
Abigail Ray, Makati City.
Sandra Flores, Manao, Pangasinan.
Avelyn Sabaya, Marino, Bulacan.
Jane Charmaine Manago, Chisami, Sausita.
Kathleen Valerosa Subijano, City of Munting Lupa. Brother Son Fernandez and Ginger Conejero.
Good evening, Philippines and fellow Earth advocates. The whole nation is filled with excitement as it eagerly awaits the crowning of the new ambassador for Mother Earth.
47 gorgeous ladies, one fabulous evening, and one coveted crown. We truly have the making for a magical night which will see one woman's dream come true.
Oh yes, so join us for the next couple of hours for an amazing race to the finish. I'm sorry guys, I just had to get at the end there. The power to save the planet is at hand, and it all begins right here, right now, in
Miss Philippines Earth 2012.
You're watching the Grand Coronation Night of Miss Philippines Earth 2012. The tradition of beauty and responsibility continues this year with 47 Admiral delegates competing to become the new Miss Philippines Earth.
Ah, well said. Now, these impressive ladies can definitely make any full-blooded male and, of course, the occasional makeup artist True. Fall head over heels completely with their arresting beauty and what makes them women of substance.
And as proof, our delegates put their minds together to come up with their very own mission statement echoing the United Nations Declaration of 2012 as the International Year of Sustainable Energy for All. Here is their pledge to save Mother Earth.
We, the Miss Philippines Earth Batch of 2012, dedicate ourselves to helping heighten the awareness of the public about the use of alternative and renewable forms of energy, geothermal, solar, hydro, and wind. By switching to renewables, we will enjoy the benefits of less emissions, independence from rising global oil prices, and free energy from natural resources. We acknowledge the importance of the promotion of energy efficiency in our everyday lives. Increasing our demands for electricity will also help equalize our distribution across the country. Through the school tours, we commit to promote energy efficiency practices, especially among the youth. We believe that energy is vital in a country's sustainable development, and renewable energy will bring us there faster.
All right, how about another round of applause to our delegates? We of course hope that you never run out of energy to inspire our lawmakers and the public to take action on this pressing environmental issue.
And of course, like our delegates, here is a group of distinguished men and women who are just as energized to punch in their scores and pick a lucky lady who will wear the Miss Philippines Earth crown. Ladies and gentlemen, our panel of judges.
We're going to start off with a dynamic publishing executive and a vanguard of ethical advertising practice. Vice President for Corporate Affairs of Business Mirror, President of the United Print Media Group, and Chairman of the Ad Board, who, incidentally, has never cheated at Scrabble.
Never.
Mr. Frederick Allegre.
The first would-be two-star general in Philippine history, the Director for Police Community Relations, Ms. General Lina Sarmiento. General, we'd like to talk to you about a parking ticket, my man.
Publisher and editor-in-chief of Travel Life magazine, the Philippines' leading travel and lifestyle publication, Ms. Christine Cunana. You're putting us on the cover of the August issue, right?
August issue cover? Yes. This is the pose already. Okay. President of SM Supermarket, the largest consumer retail chain at the forefront, I repeat, forefront of promoting the green way of shopping, Mr. Joey Mendoza, sir. SM, can you validate our ticket? We've been here since 6 a.m. Grabe.
Thank you.
80 pesos at least. Nako.
All right, next up we have one of ABS-CBN's prime artists, branded as the Empress of Drama. Miss Empress Shook. Wow, she's the Empress of Drama? That's like Ginger. Isn't she the Queen of Drama?
We have the Empress of Drama and the Queen of Drama, Ginger. All right. Filipino-American socio-ecological entrepreneur and the man behind the BAM ecological technology, the creator of BAM Bike and BAM Bowtie. In fact, he's donning one right now. Mr. Brian Benitez McClellan. Welcome, sir. Great technology. Wonderful technology. These great suits, guys, these suits?
Bamboo.
These mics?
Bamboo.
All right, next up we have the corporate general manager of Best Western Premier F1 Hotel, the first premier hotel at the fort, and official residence of the Miss Philippines Earth 2012 delegates, Mr. Rafi Chico. Mr. Chico, presidential suite?
Thank you. Champagne room, actually. Anyway, we'll talk to you later, sir. All right, hailed by Google as one of the most influential women in Philippines for 2010 and definitely one of the loveliest faces in Philippine politics, Valenzuela City Councilor Shalani Soledad Romulo. She's important. All right.
An honorable senator of the Republic, the son of a distinguished statesman from Cagayan de Oro and an educator from Zambales, a bar top-notcher and an advocate of the concerns of the youth, OFWs, electrical reform, and justice. Senator Coco Pimentel III.
No, he's not a senator. No, don't even mess with him. All right. A Philippine-born British actress, model, TV host, and extensive traveler. That's kind of like us. All right. And an avid humanitarian and a captivating James Bond girl. Definitely us. All right. Miss Rachel Grant, welcome, madam.
His diplomatic career spans more than two decades, which includes tours of duty in the Vatican City, the United Nations, and Australia. Ambassador extraordinary and plenipotentiary of Indonesia to the Philippines, and chairperson of the Board of Judges, His Excellency Johannes Cristiano Legowo.
Plenipotentiary?
Yes.
What does that mean?
Awesome.
It means awesome.
Okay. That's right. And I see a lot of plenipotentiary on stage right now.
There is a lot of plenipotentiary on stage. Ooh, that's going to hurt. Never get a job again. All right. Another round of applause, please, for our distinguished board of judges. We'd also like to thank... Another round of applause, please, for our distinguished board of judges. Okay. In English. Nice. We'd also like to thank, of course, the auditing firm of SGV and Company, our official tabulator, and Red Fox, our computer provider for tonight's pageant. Now, Mark, it goes without saying the judges have the toughest seat in the house. Would not want to be in their shoes. They got a big challenge ahead of them.
That's right. And speaking of challenge, after the break, our friend Ginger will share with us what our delegates went through to make it to the finals. The excitement continues when we return here in Miss Philippines Earth 2012.
I'm feeling sexy and free, like glitter's raining on me. You're like a shot of pure gold. I think I'm about to explode. I can taste the tension like a cloud of smoke in the air. Now I'm breathing like I'm running, cause you're taking me there. Don't you know?
Like the bass drum, sparking up a rhythm.
the top 10 is the first crucial hurdle our delegates have to surpass. Now this year, in addition to the swimsuit, evening gown, and talent competitions, Miss Philippines Earth decided to throw in a few more tests to find a more in-depth look at the special qualities of every delegate. Now let me explain. Each challenge has a corresponding point, and the total points they won, or they actually contributed together, is now factored into their preliminary score, which helps determine this year's top 10. So at this point, let's take a peek at the highlights of the pre-pageant competitions, and let's find out who led the pack.
The challenges kicked off during the press conference at SM Mall of Asia. Miss Tabuk emerged as winner of the MOB Challenge, which started at SM North EDSA, where our ladies promoted green bags to shoppers of SM Supermarket, SM Save More, SM Hypermart, and SM Marketplace. Miss San Juan topped the Grocery and Budget Challenge at SM North EDSA, also where Miss Kainta won the Trivia Challenge. Miss Makati led the Makeup Challenge at SM Makati. Miss Kainta fronted the winning art piece at the Environmental Fair Challenge at SM Mall of Asia. Miss Quezon City bagged the Catwalk and Styling Challenge Award at the SM Mega Mall. Wit and endurance of our Eco Warriors were witnessed at the Pinoy Games Challenge held at SM Mall of Asia. Our ladies concocted economical and nutritious dishes to the Cooking Challenge at SM Fairview. Each team did their own rendition of the Woman of the Earth theme song at the Dance and Singing Challenge at SM Dasmariñas, and revealed the complete beauty transformation at the Ambush Makeover Challenge at SM Mall of Asia. Mr. Gerard Poe of Nestle Fruit Selection Yogurt awarded Miss San Juan City the winner of the swimsuit competition at Golden Sunset Resort, Calatagan, Batangas. Miss Manao of Pangasinan received the Best in Cultural Attire Award from Mayor Paulino Salvador Liachon at Calapan, Mindoro. Miss Tabuk topped the Resort Wear Competition Award by Mr. Tommy Tantoco at the Pontefino Hotel and Residences. Mayor Edward Hagedorn and Madam Ellen Hagedorn awarded Miss Quezon City at the Long Gown Competition held at Puerto Princesa, Palawan. Rosal CEO Mr. Alan Rojas awarded Miss Marilao Bulacan the winner of the talent competition, where Miss Pagadian City got the Miss Photogenic title from Onan Mas and Mark Salesino of Ever Belena, and Mr. Ricky Reyes labeled Miss Lucena City as Miss Friendship. And finally, the ladies faced the ultimate and most difficult challenge as they flaunted beauty and brains in front of a fierce line of judges at the pre-judging event held at the Best Western Premier F1 Hotel.
Congratulations to all of the winners of our special challenges and our special awards. Now, could these little triumphs be a precursor to tonight's competition? We'll soon find out the answer to that question. But allow me first to introduce to you, ladies and gentlemen, the members of Carousel Productions who year in and year out produce world-class beauty pageants. Let's begin by getting to know them a little bit more. Vice President for External Relations, Miss Ping Valencia. Vice President and Project Director, Miss Peachy Veneracion. Executive Vice President, Miss Lorraine Shook. And the President of Carousel Productions, the very handsome Mr. Ramon Monzon. I know, that was a good one. A round of applause for our executives of Carousel. Thank you so much for all of your hard work. Now, good news for Carousel and this pageant, because this year Carousel joins forces with the country's largest consumer retail company to get people more involved in saving Mother Earth. Now, the SM Food Group has paved the way for the use of recyclable green bags in shopping, which has significantly reduce the harmful impact of plastic bags to the environment. Well, tonight we are honored to have with us the members of SM Food Group, and congratulations to this new partnership.
Spell on me, you hit me like the sky fell on me, and I decided you look well on me, so let's go somewhere no one else can see you and me. Turn the lights out now, now I'll take you by the hand, hand you another drink, drink it if you can. Can you spend a little time, time is slipping away, away from us, so stay, stay with me, I can make you glad you came. The sun goes down, the stars come out, and all that counts is here and now. My universe will never be the same. I'm glad you came. I'm glad you came. You cast a spell on me, spell on me. You hit me like the sky fell on me, fell on me. And I decided you look well on me, well on me. So let's go somewhere no one else can see you and me. Turn the lights out now, now I'll take you by the hand. Hand you another drink, drink it if you can. Can you spend a little time? Time is slipping away, away from us, so stay. Stay with me, I can make you glad you came. The sun goes down, the stars come out, and all that counts is here and now. My universe will never be the same. I'm glad you came, I'm glad you came. Spell on me, you hit me like the sky fell on me, fell on me. And I decided you look well on me, well on me. So let's go somewhere no one else can see you and me. Turn the lights out now, now I'll take you by the hand. Hand you another drink, drink it if you can. Can you spend a little time? Time is slipping away, away from us, so stay. Stay with me, I can make you glad you came. The sun goes down, the stars come out, and all that counts is here and now. My universe will never be the same. I'm glad you came, I'm glad you came. The sun goes down, the stars come out, and all that counts is here and now. My universe will never be the same. I'm glad you came, I'm glad you came.
We're back and the energy has reached fever pitch here at SM Center Stage, and even more so amongst the guys in the audience.
Ah, yes. Now, Mark, I've been very fortunate enough to trek some of the most prestigious mountains around the world, dove in some of the most exotic locales, even raced all the way around the world to lose. But I've never seen such a natural wonder as this.
What natural wonder is that?
The assembly of gorgeous ladies in form-fitting swimsuits.
Duh. Okay.
I am mentally high-fiving you right now.
High five. All right, moving along. Featuring the collection of swimwear designer Ricky Abbott with a touch of glam from SM Accessories and Parisienne Shoes, here are 47 reasons to stay glued to your seats. This is the Miss Philippines Earth 2012 Swimsuit Parade.
We'll be right back. performance of the Miss Philippines Earth in the swimsuit parade. Ladies and gentlemen, if you admire beauty and grace, a round of applause, please.
Well, it sure is a sight to behold. All 47 ladies. But, sadly, it's time to get down to business and make the first cut. Just about now.
We will now announce the first 5 delegates who made it to the top 10 based on their preliminary scores. May we call on Mr. Ramon Dizon, senior partner of SGV & Company, to hand us the list of our first 5 finalists.
Thank you very much, sir. Mr. Dizon. All right, here we go. In no particular order, the first final spot goes to, from San Juan City, Samantha Pervor.
Representing the province of Negros Oriental, take your spot, Glenna Cristina Duke.
Another lucky lady has her star shining down on her tonight. From the municipality of San Francisco, Cebu, Princess Linda Manzon.
You are one step closer to the crown, representing the Book City, Jennifer Perino.
Ladies and gentlemen, the 5th spot belongs to, from Puerto Princesa City, Doreen Halverson.
Congratulations, ladies. We'll soon reveal the other half of our finalists, plus the much-awaited evening gown, when Miss Philippines Earth returns.
Now, as the most relevant beauty search in the land, Miss Philippines Earth underscores that with beauty comes a duty to protect the environment. Now, during the past couple of months, this year's hopefuls didn't mind getting their pretty little hands dirty. Let's find out what's kept them busy.
What makes a woman truly beautiful? Is it her delicate hands? Her gorgeous legs? Maybe her lips or her eyes? In Miss Philippines Earth, what makes a woman truly beautiful is her willingness to contribute, to learn, to join forces with others, to experience, to teach, to influence, to inspire, and to create a positive change in the society. Miss Philippines Earth, beauties for a cause.
Beautiful and definitely responsible. Now these are the trademarks of the women of Miss Philippines Earth. Now it's time to take a short break, but do stick around because the dazzling evening gown parade is coming up with a special performance from Boys Are Boys. We'll be right back.
When the sun goes down, 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 boy, you afraid of the dark, dark. And when the lights go out, 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 tell me, do you know where to start, start? And when the bass all over my skin. I can get enough, 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 'cause the beat keep pulling me in, taking me so high up, 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 place that I've never been. Party, party all night, 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 sleep all day, then do it again, again. We got the intuition and the night.
Now, you know what? It is absolutely amazing, Mark, how a woman can transform from sassy chick to sophisticated work of art.
Yeah, that's right, because we do that every Friday night, right?
Sally?
Oh my God, Melinda?
Anyway, we're about to see that transformation tonight.
All right, together with today's hottest charmers, Alex, Brian, Marky, and JM, also known as Boys Are Boys, here now are the delegates in their resplendent evening gown parade.
To describe all the feeling that I have hiding here for you inside. You don't know how many times I wish that I had told you. You don't know how many times I wish that I could hold you. You don't know how many times I wish that I could mold you into someone who could cherish me as much as I cherish you. I treasure you, my love. this I've been waiting for you. going for. You're turning heads when you walk through the door. Don't need makeup to cover up. Being the way that you are is enough. Everyone else in the room can see it. Everyone else but you. Be your light of my world like nobody else. Like when you turn your head against me, overwhelmed. But when you smile at the ground, it ain't hard to tell. You don't know.
Awesome. How about another big round of applause for all of our delegates, ladies and gentlemen? All right, we have 47 lovely ladies still standing proudly on stage, and 42 of them are waiting to find out what their fate is for tonight's competition.
We will soon find out who will complete this year's top 10 after a few words from our lovely sponsors. Don't you dare go away.
All right, you're still watching the Grand Coronation Night of Miss Philippines Earth 2012.
Now, before we announce the final five, we will move on to the final round. We'll take this time to recognize one exceptional delegate who personifies the ideals of the SM Food Group.
Ah, yes, the very coveted title of the SM Green Bag Ambassadress. Now, the award is given to the delegate who is service-oriented and, more importantly, has that genuine care for the environment.
Aww.
And she is, of course, representing Antipolo City, Miss Leigh Marzonia.
Presenting the award is SM Supermarket President, Mr. Joey Mendoza.
Ambassadress. Isn't that also where the ambassador lives, the ambassadress?
Yes, that's where the plenipotentiary. And now, the moment of truth. We shall now find out the next five delegates who are still in the running for the Miss Philippines Earth crown. May we call on Mr. Ramon Dizon to hand us the all-important envelope.
Hello, sir. Mark, I don't trust myself. Go ahead and take it. Thank you, Paul.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, before we read out the names of those who will move on in the competition, let us please give a warm round of applause to all of our delegates for proudly representing their hometowns. Good luck, ladies. All right, here we go. Once again, in random order and based on their preliminary scores, our next finalist is from Quezon City, Stephanie Diane Stefanowicz.
Joining our elite circle of 10, Phil Belgium, Roxanne Corley.
All right, the spotlight is now on you. From Muntinlupa City, Kathleen Subihano.
Two spots left. Please take one. This municipality of Indap Cavite, Jenny Lu Tilitili.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, there is only one spot left. Who do you think it's going to be?
One more. Who's it going to, guys?
All right, well, ladies and gentlemen, completing our top 10 is from Vegan City, Mary Candice Ramos. All right, and may we now please ask our other final five contestants to come and join this final five on stage to make up the final 10.
And that completes the elite circle of 10 finalists. Let's see what our former Philippines heir, good old Miss Ginger, has to say.
Well, first off, guys, congratulations to all of our finalists. You know what, from my experience, the suspense only gets more intense with the crucial Q&A portion. Now, that's coming up in just a bit. But before we do that, the Little Earth Angels search has continued to draw crowds. Now, let's find out who emerged this year as victorious winners.
The power to save this big world is in their little hands. These pretty little girls prove that they can be our inspirational eco-guardians at the Little Earth Angel Search at the SM Mall of Asia. Escorted on stage by their environmental big sisters of the Miss Philippines Earth 2012, where they surprised the audience with their amazing talents, taught us how a little green act can save the earth in a big way, and gave us new angels to look up to and keep the earth safe and clean. Welcome, Little Earth Angels 2012, Alexis and Navarro.
You're insecure, don't know what for. You're turning heads when you walk through the door. Don't need makeup to cover up. Being the way that you are is enough. Everyone else in the room can see it. Everyone else but you. Baby, you're lying.
up my world like nobody else. The way that you flip your hair gets me overwhelmed. But when you smile at the ground, it ain't hard to tell.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, we're back in SM Center Stage for the Make It or Break It part of the competition, the question and answer portion. We're going to start off with the first batch of finalists wearing the indigenous couture collection of top Filipino fashion label, Tangan, with accessories by Adante of Tangan. Alright, ladies, this is how it goes. This bowl over here contains the names of our judges. You will pick the name of a judge who will then ask you a question. You will have 30 seconds to respond, and once you hear this warning chime, that means that you have 10 seconds left. Now, when the second alarm goes off, that means that your time is up. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, so let's begin. We're going to start off with San Juan City, Miss Samantha Pervor. Okay, Samantha, can you please pick a card? All right, and your judge is Councillor Shalani Soledad Romulo.
Hello, good evening. My question is, do you agree that it's more fun in the Philippines and why?
Definitely. I actually say there's more sun in San Juan, and one of our greatest gifts in San Juan is that we're a very warm city and we're a very welcoming city, and to add, it's a reflection of the culture of the Philippines, and I'm very happy that I'm part of San Juan City and that we are part of the whole of the Philippines, and that is definitely more sun and fun in San Juan.
All right, thank you very much, Samantha. All right, our next finalist is from Negros Oriental, Glenna Duke. All right, Glenna, please take a card. All right, you've picked Miss Empress Shook.
Hi, good evening.
Good evening.
Your question is, what do you think are the specific causes of climate change?
There are many causes of climate change, and one of them is carbon dioxide presence in our atmosphere. But through this year's theme, the International Year for Sustainable Energy, we can reduce that by many, many things that we do, and we can stop climate change, because climate change is caused by things like pollution, and this year, we can make a stop to that. Thank you and good evening.
All right, thank you very much, Glenna. Next up, from the municipality of San Francisco, Cebu, Princess Mazon. All right. Your judge is General Lina Sarmiento.
Hi, good evening. Your question is, in the Philippine setting, which type of renewable energy would you promote and why?
I would promote solar energy here in the Philippines because it's always sunny here in the Philippines. We're a very tropical islands, and I think it's very accessible to everyone because every day there's always sun here in the Philippines.
Thank you very much. All right. Our fourth finalist now is from Tabuk City, Glennifer Perido. All right, Glennifer, please pick a card. All right, the judge that you have picked is Miss Christine Cunanan.
Hello. Do you support our country's push for more tourism, which will mean a better economy for our country, even if this means more damage to our natural resources or more pollution, more people?
Well, for me, if we should promote the Philippines, like, to improve it economically, well, we should study the pros and cons. Especially, we must consider the environment. We must learn to conserve and protect and restore the environment. We should first prioritize in protecting it because we must nurture the nature for the future generation. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Glennifer. All right, our fifth and final finalist for this first batch is from Puerto Princesa City, Thoreen Halverson. Hi, Thoreen, please pick a card. All right, the judge that you've picked is Mr. Brian Benitez McClellan.
The Underground River in Palawan was just nominated and awarded one of the 7 natural wonders of the world. Given this influx of new tourism which we're expecting, how can you best suggest that we manage tourism there so that we can preserve it for the future generations?
Well, there's a concept which is ecotourism, which is showing the balance between development and environment. And I'm very proud that in Puerto Princesa City, we have the carrying capacity wherein every tourist is only 500 per day to sustain the environment. Thank you.
All right. Thank you very much. All right. Well, there you have it, ladies. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. 5 down and 5 more to go. We'll continue to probe the minds of our next batch of finalists right after this break. So make sure you stay with us.
The excitement continues here in the Miss Philippines Earth as we get a closer look at our finalists wearing original and contemporary Filipino outfits from Tangan with matching Adante accessories. Are you ready, ladies? Take a deep breath. No, that was for me. All right, you know the drill. Here we go. Starting with Quezon City, Miss Stephanie Stefanowicz. Please select your judge. Notice she is helping me open it. Miss Rachel Grant, the floor is yours, madam.
Hello. This is my question. If you were a superhero, what power would you choose to have? And how would you use it to save the earth?
Definitely, I would be a superhero with the power to clean up the whole environment. My advocacy is the conservation and preservation of our environment, not only for ourselves, but of course for the future generations as well. And as a citizen, it is essential for us to realize how today's decision affects tomorrow's generation. Thank you very much.
Well done. Thank you, Ms. Stephanie. Please, continuing on, Phil Belgium, Miss Roxanne Corlo. Go ahead and select your judge. Thank you. You have selected Mr. Rafi Chico.
Good evening, Miss Belgium.
Good evening.
Phil Belgium, actually. How can winning Miss Earth title help
push forward environmental concerns.
The title of Miss Earth is one that can influence a lot of people to think more about what they can do for the environment. Even as a small-time user, there are many changes you can make in your daily lifestyle that can help our future generation. As a Miss Earth ambassador, I hope to encourage people and teach people ways that they can conserve our environment for the future generation.
Thank you, Ms. Roxanne. Well done. May I ask to join me on the lower stage, representing Muntinlupa City, Ms. Kathleen Subihano. Take your mark. Go ahead and select your judge. Thank you very much. All right, you have selected the Honorable Mr. Frederick Alegre, sir. The floor is yours.
Good evening, Ms. Muntinlupa.
Good evening.
Knowing that children play a major role in preserving our environment, how would you explain the importance of energy conservation to a child?
I have a niece, and she's only about 10 years old. And when I'm gone, she's going to be the one who's going to watch over the earth. She's going to be the one who's preserving the environment in place of this generation. And I will explain the importance of energy conservation to her, because every time we use more energy than we need, we contribute more carbon emissions to the earth, and that contributes to climate change, and it affects millions of lives whenever we do that. Thank you very much.
Nicely done. Thank you very much. Please take your place. Whew. Two more to go. From the municipality of Indang, Shadilu Dili Dili. Love your name. Go ahead and select your judge. All right. I will read. You have selected Senator Coco Pimentel. Sir, the floor is yours.
Hi, Ms. Indang. What is the most important thing about the environment which you have learned from joining Miss Philippines Earth?
Of course, I would say in line with the Declaration of the United Nations in the year 2012, I would say environmental sustainability. In order to preserve our natural resources, we should all conserve it and save it for the future generation. I believe that if we will be able to save our environment, our future generation will not only benefit from it, but will be rich in the future.
Thank you, Ms. J.D. Liu. And of course, last but certainly not least, representing Vegan City, Ms. Mary Candice Ramos. Hello. Of course, there is no question for you, but this will be coming from the Honorable Indonesian Ambassador Legowo, and he will say it in Indonesian. I'm just kidding. Continue, sir.
Good evening, Ms. Vegan. What is the biggest environmental issue here in the Philippines? And if you have a chance to meet the president, what would you recommend to address the issue?
Given that this year is the year for sustainable energy for all, I think that we should address right now the issue of sustainable energy. But of course, the most important thing is to address first the issue in the government, the issue in the values of every Filipino family, the issue in the quality of education, and the issue in our social economy. That's all, and thank you.
Thank you very much. Well done. All right. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. And of course, thank you, ladies. The dreaded Q&A portion is done, and you all passed with flying colors. Aside from the privilege of representing the Philippines in the prestigious Miss Earth pageant later on this year, our winner will be showered with an array of fabulous prizes fit for a queen. Here's a look at what awaits the new Miss Philippines Earth and her court.
Philippines Earth 2012 and her court will receive the following prizes: 1 year supply of top-of-the-line Ever Balena cosmetic products to ensure their ever beautiful aura during their entire reign. Ever Balena cosmetics, beauty in you. Gift certificates from Alberto. Shoes that fit your lifestyle. Original crystals and precious stones that could bring luck from Charms and Crystals International by Miss Joy Lim. Let your charms turn your wishes to reality. Sleek, sexy, and stylish laptops from Red Fox. Red Fox redefines the lives of Filipinos all over the world through innovative laptops, desktops, tablets, and other computing solutions. Copa window-type air conditioners with the R410A eco-friendly refrigerant. Save energy, go green, go Copa. 1-year Gold's Gym memberships valid in any of their branches. Gold's Gym, know your own strength. Limited Naomi pearl necklaces. Retailing fine jewelry art pieces that are handmade fused with natural gemstones and diamonds from all over the world. 1-year supply of skin and body care services from Janssen. Nobody does it better. Janssen Cosmetic Surgery of Dr. John Seneca. Shoes from Skechers. Stylish and fun. Premium dermatological services worth 500,000 pesos from Beverly Hills 6750. 5-night stay at the 4th Suite for Miss Philippines Earth 2012, while Miss Philippines Air, Water, Fire, and Ecotourism will enjoy 5-night stay in a deluxe suite courtesy of F1 Hotel, the first premier hotel at the fort and the official residence of the Miss Philippines Earth 2012 pageant. Canon PIXMA MP287 printers for incredible printing speed with superlative quality. Plus, Miss Philippines Earth 2012 will capture precious memories in vivid and crisp photos with her new Canon Digital IXUS 1000 HS camera. 1 million pesos worth of scholarship grants from Metropolitan Medical Center College of Arts, Science, and Technology, MMC CAST, your passport to a global career. The Miss Philippines Earth 2012 winner will be receiving the following: a beautiful diamond, pearl, and gold jewelry perfected in timeless elegance worth 50,000 pesos from the Amberito collection of Emily Lier Jewelers, and a management contract from Carousel Productions will have the honor of wearing the Miss Philippines Earth crown during her reign.
Welcome back. Last year, a young lady from Casiguran, Aurora, stole the hearts of many and stood out with her striking beauty and unique character. Now, she went on to carry the Philippine standard with great pride. With the Greek goddess of wisdom for a namesake, she proved to the country and to the world that beauty comes with a sharp mind. Sa huling pagkakataon bilang Miss Philippines Earth, ladies and gentlemen, narito po muli si Athena Imperial.
Lahat ng pinagkaloob ay may hangganan. Ang araw matapos magliwanag ay lumulubog sa dapit hapon. Ang bulaklak matapos mamukadkad ay nalalanta. Ang oras kahit tila gaano kabagal ay mabilis na lumilipas. Tila kahapon lang nang ipinutong sa akin ng korona. Ang sandaling iyon ay patunay na kasisihan ng Diyos ang dalangin kung ito ay ukol sa iyo. Isang karangalan ang maging tinatawan ng Pilipinas para sa kalikasan. At ang mga tungkuling kalakit ng karangalang ito ay niyabos ko ng walang pag-aalinlangan. Nais kong pasalamatan ang mga taong nagsilbing lakas ng aking loob upang magtagumpay. Kina Muriel, Jonah V, Michelle at Denise, salamat sa pagkakaibigan. Masasalamat din sa Carousel Productions at Miss Earth Foundation sa paggabay at sa mga pinto ng oportunidad na inyong binuksan para sa akin. Ito ay hindi pamamaalam pagkus isang pagbubugay sa karagdagang taong inilaan para sa inang kalikasan. Ang pagkalinga ng bawat Pilipino sa kalikasan ay katumbas ng taas noong pagwagayway ng pandila ng lahing kanyang gabi. Maraming salamat, magandang gabi sa at-tanan.
Thank you.
course, congratulations to her court. Miss Philippines Air, Jonavi Kirai. Miss Philippines Water, Muriel Orais. Miss Philippines Fire, Michelle Gavagan. And Miss Philippines Ecotourism, Denise Toribio. We wish you all the very best long after your reign is over. And thank you so much for being a part of the Miss Philippines Earth cause. Now, Mark and Roselson, I would like to thank, I would also like to speak of partnerships and the continuing partnership that we have formed this evening. Now, SM Food Group awarded the SM Green Bag Ambassadress earlier this evening to Lay Denise Marzonia from Antipolo City. Now, she received an SM Prestige card loaded, preloaded with 100,000 points of credit. And congratulations again to Miss Antipolo. 100,000 points worth of credit.
That's
I wonder
amazing.
What that translates to.
Wow, that is
very, very impressive.
Maybe we could ask her for some of her points. All right. Now, we also would like to thank, at this point, I'd like to thank Lloyd Arceo for my gown. You'd also, you guys also want to say thank you to the people who provided your stunning suits this evening and made you look better. That's Philip Tampos and Odilion Simpao
yes.
For the guys' outfits. I'd
yes.
also like to thank Nizelle Reduta for my hair and makeup.
All right. Okay, well, ladies and gentlemen, this is it. After 2 months of intense competition, it all boils down to this final moment.
Ooh, it's happening. All right, now the judges have made their decision. The scores have been tabulated and verified by SGV and company. And here is good old Mr. Ramon Dizon to hand us the results. Good luck, ladies.
Thank you very much.
The answers everyone's been waiting for. But let's remind our audience, all of our finalists are already winners.
Absolutely.
5 of them are this year's runners-up, and the other 5 will take home the crowns. Good luck again, ladies.
That is absolutely correct. All right, we're going to start off with Miss Philippines Ecotourism. Miss Philippines Ecotourism 2012 is... From Vegan City, Mary Candice Ramos.
Grabbing Miss Philippines Ecotourism are Miss Earth Foundation Executive Director Miss Kathy Untalan and Miss Philippines Ecotourism 2011, Denise Toribio.
Miss Philippines Fire. I've already been handed the envelope. Thank you, sir. Miss Philippines Fire is representing Puerto Princesa City, Doreen Halverson.
Crowning Miss Philippines Fire are Carousel Productions Vice President for External Relations, Miss Bing Valencia, and Miss Philippines Fire 2011, Michelle Gavagan.
Our winners are continuing. Next in line is Miss Philippines Water. Ladies and gentlemen, she is none other than... From San Juan City, Samantha Perver.
Running Miss Philippines Water are Carousel Productions Vice President and Project Director Miss Peachy Veneracion and Miss Philippines Water 2011, Muriel Orais.
Have the title previously held by our lovely co-host. No, not you, Mark. Oh, Ginger!
I could give it to you, though.
Miss Philippines Air is... representing the Book City, Miss Glennifer Benito!
Crowning Miss Philippines Air, Carousel Productions Executive Vice President, Miss Lorraine Shook, and Miss Philippines Air 2011, Junavi Kirai.
Ladies and gentlemen, we only have one name left, and that is for Miss Philippines Earth 2012. Who do you think it's going to be, audience? Who's your bet? Scream it out loud. I want to hear you. All right. Well, ladies and gentlemen, Miss Philippines Earth 2012 is from Quezon City, Stephanie Diane Stefanowicz.
Crowning Miss Philippines Earth are Carousel Productions President Mr. Ramon Monzon and Miss Philippines Earth 2011 Athena Imperial.
Congratulations to the new Miss Philippines Earth, Stephanie Stefanowicz, and her court. We wish you a successful year and all the best in continuing the tradition of beauty and responsibility.
On behalf of Carousel Productions and SM Food Group, we say goodbye for now, but we do hope to see you again next year for Miss Philippines Earth 2013.
This special was brought to you by SM Food Group in cooperation with Kitco Travel and Miss Earth Foundation.